It gives me immense pleasure to invite you and your family to celebrate with us this momentous event of establishing the Jasubhai Memorial Endowment at our institute. Now I call upon stage Professor Atul Dixit for the invocation.
जय जय हे भगवती सुर भारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। जय जय हे भगवती सुर भारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। नाद ब्रह्ममयी जय वागीश्वरी नाद ब्रह्ममयी जय वागीश्वरी शरणं ते गच्छामः। जय जय हे भगवती सुरभारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। त्वमसि शरण्या त्रिभुवन धन्या सुरमुनि वन्दित चरणा। त्वमसि शरण्या त्रिभुवन धन्या सुरमुनि वन्दित चरणा। नवरस मधुरा कविता मुखरा नवरस मधुरा कविता मुखरा स्मित रुचि रुचिरा भरणा। स्मित रुचि रुचिरा भरणा। जय जय हे भगवती सुर भारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। जय जय हे भगवती सुर भारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। आसीना भव मानस हंसे आसीना भव मानस हंसे आसीना भव। आसीना भव मानस हंसे कुन्दतु हि न शशि धवले। हर जडताङ्कुर बोधि विकासन हर जडताङ्कुर बोधि विकासन स्थित पंकज तनु विमले। स्थित पंकज तनु विमले। जय जय हे भगवती सुर भारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। नाद ब्रह्ममयी जय वागीश्वरी नाद ब्रह्ममयी जय वागीश्वरी शरणं ते गच्छामः। जय जय हे भगवती सुर भारती तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। तव चरणौ प्रणमामः। तव चरणौ प्रणमामः।
Thank you, sir, for the mesmerizing performance. It's always a pleasure to hear you. Now I kindly request the dignitaries on the stage to please light the lamp. Thank you, sir. Now I would like to call upon stage our Dean for Campus Development, who has worked relentlessly to make our campus the scenic beauty it is today. Our very own professor, Mr. Harish PM.
Thank you. A very warm welcome to all of you. This is a proud moment for the campus. In its relatively short existence, this is an important milestone for us to be partnering with Jasubhai Foundation and naming this auditorium Jasubhai Memorial Auditorium. So IIT Gandhinagar was established in 2008, and right from the initial years, it has had a very innovative and vibrant culture. It has seen itself as a different IIT doing many things differently. In fact, the innovations in our undergraduate curriculum have been acknowledged widely and has been recognized by the World Education Summit as the most innovative undergraduate program in the country and by FICCI as the University of the Year last year. So in this short period, we've also established a number of centers of excellence in various unique and diverse research areas. Some of these areas include safety, cognitive sciences, archaeological sciences, sustainable development, to name a few. IIT Gandhinagar is also establishing an industry research park at the moment. So among the IITs that were established in 2008-2009, IIT Gandhinagar was, in fact, the last IIT to be allotted land, which happened in July 2012. But we were the first IIT to complete constructions, move to the permanent campus, and completely vacate the temporary campus. This was... So this has been a very important milestone for us. The campus has also won a lot of accolades. One of them, this is the first campus in the country to be rated 5-star under the Griha LD category, which applies to large developments, for its low environmental impact and energy efficiency. The campus has also won 3 HUDCO awards. In fact, the most recent one of them being announced just yesterday, wherein the academic complex here won the first prize in the green buildings category. So this auditorium, of course, is one of the centerpieces of this academic complex. And this has been designed with simplicity and elegance in mind, but at the same time having the flexibility to host major functions of various kinds. The furniture here has also been designed with the same philosophy, simplicity and elegance. In fact, Professor Jain's very specific brief was that the furniture should be simple, elegant, but robust enough to last 50 years. So that was the approach we took. And in fact, each piece here has been crafted with CNC machines and laser cutting machines, thus adding a modern technological touch to the furniture. So having gone through this journey, today is indeed a proud moment for the campus to have Mr. Jasubhai Shah's family here, to have his wife, Mrs. Shweta Shah here, to have Mr. Malik Jasubhai and family here. And of course, I'm particularly delighted to have Mr. B. Narayan here from Reliance Industries Group, and he's president of procurement and projects. I hope this will be the first of his many visits here to IIT Gandhinagar. We are also excited to have the string quartet from the Indian National Youth Orchestra performing here later today. I'm looking forward to that. So at this point, I will call upon stage Mrs. Shweta Shah, and I will request Professor Jain to welcome her. Please, ma'am. I will also request Professor Jain to welcome Mr. Maulik Jasubhai and our guest, Mr. B. Narayan. So once again, a very warm welcome to Mr. Narayan, Mrs. Shweta Shah, Mr. Maulik Jasubhai, his family, representatives of the Jasubhai Foundation, representatives of Chemtech Foundation, the String Quartet from Indian National Youth Orchestra, and all guests. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Harish Pia. Now I would like to introduce to you Mr. Maulik Jasubhai. Mr. Maulik Jasubhai is the chairman and the chief executive officer of the Jasubhai Group, which includes Jasubhai Engineering, Jasubhai Media, Chemtech Foundation, and the Jasubhai Foundation. He is passionate about the student outreach program, an initiative of Chemtech Foundation, launched by the founder chairman, Mr. Jasu Shah, which aims at developing future leaders for the industry. Currently, he is spearheading the Indian and the international operations of Jasubhai Engineering Private Limited. He is also the founder CEO of Jasubhai Digital Media, a pioneering IT media company with brands like Digit, Chip, ZDNet.com. I kindly request Mr. Maulik Jasubhai to please address us.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, friends, family, distinguished guests on the dais, dear friends, and all the well-wishers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for taking the time and being here with us. I especially want to thank a lot of our friends who have flown in specifically only for this function, and BN in particular, and I know there are several other business friends and family friends who have flown in for this. Today is an emotional day for me. Today is Papa's first birth anniversary after his demise last year. He was born on 10th of February, 1937. When we were leaving in the morning from home, my younger daughter, she says, you know, I miss Dada, and I'd like to do something or say something about him in his memory. So she decided that she said, I'm not a speaker, but if you permit me, I will play a small piece on my viola in his memory. I hope you will indulge her afterwards. You know, whenever we grow up, most of the time our friends or family or parents ask you, says, you know, I hope you become a big industrialist. I hope you become a great doctor. I hope you become a great scientist. When I was growing up, and I'm talking about when I was growing up, when I was in like 8th standard, 9th standard, or younger, when I was growing up, my father would often tell me that I want you to be a philanthropist. I had absolutely no idea what that word meant in those days. But this is the absolute truth. He said, become a philanthropist, and I didn't know what to do about it at that time. He often repeated, he said, whatever little inheritance that you will have, treat it as a trust. Give it back in greater measure than what you receive. We are a small family business, and we are not some large corporate house. We are not a big publicly listed company. However, this endowment is absolutely in keeping with his philosophy, his desire, and perhaps a small step for me trying to become a philanthropist. I came to IIT Gandhinagar about 8 months ago, or 6 months ago. and to meet Professor Jain. There was no specific agenda set. I said, you know, I'd like to come and see you. And his dynamism and his magnetism, we literally hit it off the cuff. On that very day, on the very first visit, I told Professor Jain, I believe in you, and I want to find a way to work with you, on the very first day. And I think that speaks a lot about Professor Jain and the kind of dedication and the kind of ideas, the vision, and absolute commitment to building a world-class institution comes from. And had it not been for Professor Jain, we probably wouldn't be here. So it is our privilege, our honor, our good fortune, our small responsibility to be associated with IIT Gandhinagar. And I want to thank Professor Jain and the entire staff of IIT and the entire faculty of IIT Gandhinagar to welcoming us to be part of the IIT Gandhinagar family. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Simran, for the wonderful performance. Now we have a special video from the Honorable Railway Minister of India.
Let me congratulate the Indian Institute of Technology, Gandhinagar, for many, many good things they are doing. But in particular now, what you are doing is very good. My very dear friend, Jasubhai Shah, was a great philanthropist, was a great industrialist, was a great human being, who did philanthropy without even his other hand knowing. His right hand didn't know what his left hand was doing. He just needs to go and give the money as he should be. As a part of our ancient tradition, they do good, but let it not known to the world. There are many people who want to buy good name by paying money. Here is a person who is doing good deed without even anybody letting know about it. He was a great, great person. Unfortunately, he passed away recently. And I'm very happy and very congratulate your organization for naming an auditorium after him. His very competent son, Maulik, and he is appropriately named as Maulik because he brings in a lot of valuable qualities in him. He'll be able to take his legacy forward. And I'm sure the students must also know the life of Jasubhai. Came from a very humble beginning and made it big purely on his own merit. Someone was born in Gujarat, came to Mumbai, went to Germany, did businesses all over the world. One of the exhibitions he started organizing, which has helped so many other businesses to grow. Somebody can imagine, he did his own business very well, but also started a Chemtech Foundation to allow the businesses to come and also grow. You know, he was also benefiting, people also benefiting, country was benefiting. Can you think about a business model like this? That nobody loses, everybody benefits, and everybody is happy. I think this is the innovation that he introduced. I think all of you must work on that. And youngsters must take inspiration from this. And that's why I'm very happy that I am able to at least offer my best wishes to all of you, because he was my very dear friend. I always miss him, always look forward to his advice, even in his own life, by just looking at how he lived, how would I face the situation, will inspire us to do something better in our own life. So all the best to you.
I would like to thank Sir for his best wishes through this video message. Now let me introduce to you our honorable chief guest for today evening, Mr. B. Narayan. He is currently the group president of procurement and projects with Reliance Industries Limited and is responsible for process licenses and engineering services for major projects, project management of capital projects, procurement of capital equipment, supply chain management of input materials, MRO items for RIL Group and companies. Now I invite Mr. B. Narayan to address us on this occasion.
Thank you for those kind introductory words. Dignitaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, faculty members, students of the Institute. I am delighted to be here amongst you this evening on the occasion of naming this hall after Jasubhai Shah. You know, if I were to describe Jasubhai in simple terms, because I had known him for over 25 years, and is a down-to-earth person, very pleasant entrepreneurial industrialist, philanthropist in thoughts and action, very dear friend, and philosopher. He always believed in supporting education, healthcare, upliftment of downtrodden, less fortunate. Always used to think of those noble ideas. And he founded Chemtech Foundation and used that as a platform for spreading knowledge, bringing in technology, products, services from all over the world, from within the country, and making them available or exposed to other industrialists who needed those exposure. So he believed in spreading the knowledge among the people. And Chemtech Foundation has been extremely active through conferences, seminars, expos, and covering various areas of oil and gas, petrochemicals, refining, pharmaceuticals, water technology, automation, and so on. Because I am also pretty much closely involved in one of those streams which Chemtech Foundation is progressing. And I'm quite impressed with activities of Chemtech Foundation. And I should actually thank Malik, who is here. And I'm also very happy that Malik has taken the baton from his father, and progressing is carrying forward his father's legacy in true earnestness and with the same vigor and genuineness as Jasupai used to do. You know, we're talking about the institution and it's very specifically the students around here. I think you have a lot to learn from Jasubai's life. As I mentioned our Honorable Minister, as well as a glimpse of what Malik talked about Jasubai, you would have gathered what a visionary he was, what a kind man he was, and how pure he was. You know, in this institute, we are actually lucky to be fortunate to have this hall today, and it's so apt that being Jasubai's birthday, IIT Gandhinagar couldn't have chosen a better day to name this hall after him, to pay tribute to this visionary personality that Jasubai was. And being here, just addressing, because why I want to mention this is because Jasubai was a good leader, and I want to actually make some mention about what a good leader is, and particularly addressing some of the students who are here. And you know, you students, you are here with a purpose, with an objective, and when you've come here, you have come with your own aspirations for success in your life. And in the meantime, simultaneously, I'm sure your parents, your neighbors, your relatives, your friends, even some of the people who have come from small villages and Mufassil towns, maybe the village by itself, would also be carrying a lot of aspirations for your success in future. Please do not disappoint them. And when you people have entered the institute, you entered in your teens. When you leave this institute, you would be past your teens. So you're actually past your prank years, you know, so to say. And when you go out of this institute, you'll be prepared to step into the competitive world Some of you may be taking up your own, pursuing your own family business. Some of you may be starting your own startup companies. And some of you may be pursuing professional career, like I have done. And some of you may be pursuing education, you know, higher education, and or even taking up the noble profession of teaching. But whatever be the case, wherever your future life you pursue with, you carry a lot of responsibilities because you are the future leaders of the society, you're the future leaders of India, the future leaders of the world, because some of you may be definitely will be playing a big role, maybe even in the world scenario. And so you need to be role model leaders, and you need to actually follow some of the role models that are there to see in history. You know, you have J.R.D. Tata, for example, or Bill Gates, and Narayan Murthy, and I would add even Jasubai. Why I say this is, as a good leader, the one who not only leads from the front, he also, while leading from the front, when he's climbing up the ladder, he helps the person on the lower rung in the ladder and helps him come up and climb up along with the himself. And that's a leader pulls the person below him to become a future leader. And that's what a good leader is. And I want all of you to be aspiring to become such role model leaders. And you know, this institute you've come to, and you will gain knowledge, you know, it's a part of your education. And when you leave, you will carry a very impressive certificate on paper. And definitely you will be prepared to take up a career, professionally or your own business or whatever it is, as I mentioned earlier. But there is another form of education. And that education is described as or defined as your attitude, your actions, your language, behavior, and personalities with other people in real life. You know, so the knowledge is connected with the mind and brain, and what I said, the latter part of the education, well, it's connected with the heart. So you have, it was only when the brain and heart are harmonized, you have a peace. And I, you know, it's maybe a piece of philosophical advice, but why I'm making special mention of this part is that is what Jasubai embodied. And he was an example of that. He had an excellent education. He was an engineer, educated in Germany, came here, took up philanthropic activities, and it's all because he was simultaneously a good human being, good citizen. And with that said, I wish all of you here the best use of this hall. It's a multifunctional hall, extremely impressive, very imposing, and I'm sure there'll be stimulating debates, lectures, actions, and the one we just had, you know, heard musical little concert, and many more of them. And this will be a place of pleasure and a place of enjoyment, and that's all what we finally look for in life. And thank you very much, Professor Jain and Maulik and the rest of you, for inviting me to the institute. This is the first visit of mine, very impressed. I am, by the way, from IIT Madras then, which is Chennai. And so I started cherishing some of my memories in the IIT campus in Chennai. And so I was going around asking Professor Jain about a few things. And I was very impressed to know that this place full of nilgais and rabbits and monkeys and all that. It's exactly the same thing that I used to experience back in Chennai. It was a literally protected deer sanctuary. So we're having thousands of deers running around us. I thank you very much for inviting me. I enjoyed my little stay here during the past couple of hours. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words and the wonderful advice you gave us. Dr. Sudhir K. Jain, our director, is a passionate academic administrator. His enthusiastic leadership has successfully created a number of initiatives to inculcate and promote excellence. Our director always succeeds in motivating the students to dream big and achieve beyond their reach through his words. Now I take this opportunity to invite him on the dais.
Mr. Narayan, Shrimati Shweta Ben Shah, Malik Bhai, esteemed guests, colleagues, students, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here today on this historical event for the Institute. This is indeed a historical day for us, a very momentous day for us to be receiving the largest endowment that IIT Gandhinagar has received from any Indian donor till date. And I hope this will be a trendsetter. I hope there will be many who will be inspired by what is happening in IIT Gandhinagar today. This is also the first occasion, this is the first opportunity when we are naming a facility after an eminent personality, that is Shri Jashubhai Shah. This is something very commonly done in some of the best universities around the world, and I hope that this will be the only first such occasion and we will have many more such opportunities. We have had a great aspiration to make an impact. We have had a clarity in our thoughts that if IIT Gandhinagar is to spend as much money of the taxpayers as a typical IIT does, it must make an impact back on the society, back on the country, back on the world. And we therefore aspire to make an impact, to address the contemporary challenges, to be the Nalanda and the Takshila of the 21st century India. And for that, we need plenty of philanthropic funds. In fact, as early as 2009, some of the well-wishers of our institute had created a charitable foundation in the United States. In 2009, when the institute was only 1 year old, we had a foundation running in California, which was given a tax-exempt status by the United States government, even though we had not yet received the tax-exempt status from the government of India at that point of time. I must say that we are very fortunate today to have one of the three founders of our foundation in the United States, Mr. Bipin Shah, who has flown in last night from Calcutta just to be with us here today. Bipin, if you don't mind, just can you get up and wave hands to everybody so people know that I'm actually talking about something real happening here. We have been very generously supported by the government of India, all IITs are, and we are very fortunate. And yet, we from inception have been saying that we are some sort of a public-private partnership. We are an institution where the routine bills, the salary bills, the electricity bills are covered by the government grants, but then we need philanthropy to take care of the excellence. And since our inception, we have been very fortunate to receive a reasonably good number of philanthropic contributions, even though we do not yet have wealthy alumni who would be naturally inclined to contribute back to their alma mater. In fact, of the undergraduate students, the BTEC students that graduated in 2016, 45% of them had one or more opportunity to be outside India fully supported for summer research or otherwise. In fact, of the 2016 batch, 25% of the alumni, those who graduated only 6 or 8 months back, about 25% of them have started to send money every month to IIT Gandhinagar and pooling their money, we have been able to create scholarships. We call them class of 2016 scholarships. And only last month, our colleagues decided who will be the first recipient of the 2016 class scholarship, a first year student. We have been providing opportunities to our PhD students to spend a semester outside. We have been bringing a lot of eminent scholars from around the world. We have been able to provide extraordinary financial support to our students and faculty, something totally unheard of in Indian academia, something not very common in the IIT system. And all of that has been possible because of philanthropic money. We are extremely grateful to Jasubhai Group, the Jasubhai family, the foundation for its financial support. This is something that is very valuable, as you understand. But there is something else that is very valuable, and that is the engagement, the involvement, the fact that today Maulik Jasubhai is sitting here, the fact that today Maulik Jasubhai has his skin in the game in the success of IIT Gandhinagar. That is very important for us. The fact that Mr. Narayan is sitting today here with us, and the fact that Mr. Narayan will perhaps go back to Bombay with some good impressions of the institute, I think all of that is extremely valuable to us, and we are looking forward to it. We are hoping to leverage their contacts. We are hoping to leverage their ideas, their thoughts, their dynamism, and we are counting on their help in more ways than just the money. I would like to express my particular gratitude to Mr. Rustam Vakil, who works with the Jasubhai Group. And Rustam Bhai, if you don't mind, can you get up and just wave hands to everybody? Rustam came to visit us first time when Maulik came, and since then he has been very actively helping to take this discussion forward together with my very esteemed colleague, Mr. Nirmal Jha, sitting on the dais here. Nirmal and Rustam have really been extremely effective in taking these discussions forward. And finally, I must express my very deep appreciation to Mr. Bijlani. He's a Thomsonian, fellow Thomsonian, a senior Thomsonian, which means in common language, which means he's a graduate of Roorkee as I am. And Mr. Bijlani and his daughter Ruhi Gurjar, if you don't mind, Bijlani Saab and Ruhi, can you get up and wave hands to everybody? They are the ones who actually introduced us to the family of the Jasubhais. That is the first time I checked in my computer today. January 2016 was the first conference call that I had with Maulik Bhai, with Ruhi joining on the call. And thank you very much for these introductions. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here today. I look forward to your engagement, your involvement, your best wishes for the growth of this institute. Thank you again.
Thank you so much, Professor Jain. The Jasubhai Foundation is a registered charitable trust established in 1984 by its founder, Mr. Jasubhai Shah, serving the people of India and committed to the cause of advancement of the arts, music, culture, health, education, and technology for both urban and rural India. Education and human development, specifically in the areas of technology, innovation, and entrepreneurship, are the motivating factors in the establishment of the Jasubhai Memorial Chair and the Jasubhai Memorial Endowment at IIT Gandhinagar. This state-of-the-art auditorium holds many of our momentous events and celebrations and has already hosted talks by two eminent Nobel laureates. May I invite the chief guest, Mr. B. Narayan, Professor Jain, Ms. Shwetaben Jasubhai, to dedicate the auditorium to the memory of Mr. Jasubhai Shah. Performing today from the Indian National Youth Orchestra is a string quartet of the orchestra comprising of violinist Mr. Sandeep and Ms. Ritu Gopal, violinist Ms. Swarnalata Adhikari, and cellist Ms. Somnath Makhal. They will present a range of Western classical works in today's concert in tribute to the memory of Mr. Jasubhai Shah, whom I wish to honor today.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.